Today, we've got five best MP5 class setups. So I pretty much have a class setup designed specifically for anybody, depending on what kind of playstyle you have or what kind of game modes you like to play. So we got a balanced MP5 class setup, aggressive, stealth, no recoil, and objective class setup. Just keep in mind that most of these attachments are going to be fairly similar, but some of the variations are going to change depending on what class setup they are. The perks are going to be a little different as well. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, join Turbo Nation today, make that official. Don't forget to consider leaving a like on this video if you do find this video helpful at any point in time. All right, let's get into it. So with the objective MP5 class setup, you do want to keep in mind that this is specifically made for game modes such as domination and hardpoint. So as far as the attachments go, we're going to go with a 9.5 inch Ranger barrel. So this one gives us that 100% bullet velocity, and bullet velocity is more important than ever in Cold War, especially on SMGs, because by default, you know, that bullet velocity is not that great on SMGs. So you could be questioning yourself sometimes, like, is my connection messing up, or how come my shots aren't hitting instantly when I'm firing my weapon at somebody? And the reason why is because of that bullet velocity. So you want to make sure that you have as much bullet velocity as possible. Another not too bad barrel is the 9.5 inch reinforced heavy barrel. So this one gives us more damage range, about 18% to be exact, and 80% bullet velocity. This one you could also run with, you know, depending on how big or small the map is. If the map is bigger, then I would definitely recommend the 9.5 inch Ranger. The reinforced heavy barrel is going to be better for a small to medium sized maps, so that way you can increase your damage range. You know, 18% is really not that much. It's literally maybe 2 or 3 meters at most, but at the same time, on a smaller map or a medium map, that's going to be a much bigger difference. We want to have the Tiger Team spotlight on the body here. This is going to allow us to spot enemies on the map, and it's also going to give you that kind of information on when to be ready for a gunfight, and that's going to be very helpful for objective type game modes. The magazine is going to be a personal choice. You know, you can use whatever you want here. You can't really go wrong with any of these. However, if you're playing an objective mode, most likely you're going to be going up against multiple enemies at a time. So I do recommend something that has that reload speed quickness, as well as enough rounds in your magazine to be able to take on multiple opponents at a time. But keep in mind, if you're going to go with the 50 round drum mag, make sure to keep an eye on how much ammo you have left, and then, you know, take cover accordingly and then reload your weapon. For the handle, we're going to be going with the airborne elastic wrap. So this one gives us 30% aim down sight time, and then 90% flinch resistance and that aim while going prone. So as far as objective game modes go, this is a pretty solid choice here because it gives you that boost in aim down sight speed. And that's going to be very important to snap onto opponents who are pushing the objective. All right, so the last attachment is going to be the Raider stock. So this one's going to give us the sprint to fire time of 30%. And also that aim walking movement speed. Secondary, you can use whatever you want, but for objective game modes, I do recommend using a Sigma. A Sigma will help you take down UAVs, aircraft, etc. And then you can also couple that with a field upgrade of the trophy system, you know, to protect you while enemies are throwing lethals and stuns at you while you're trying to hold down the objective. This is very, very helpful. It literally inhales the grenades and the stuns. It's super, super helpful in those situations. Lethal, you can use whatever you want, but I just use Semtex. Tactical, it's a personal preference. You can either go with a flashbang or a stun grenade. You want to run the perk Greed Wildcard. That way we're able to use all these perks here. Tactical Mask, Flak Jacket, Scavenger, Gearhead, Cold Blood, and Ghost. All right, so moving on to the No Recoil MP5. This is one of my personal favorites because obviously who doesn't like guns that don't have recoil? That's going to result in you winning a lot more gunfights. Keep in mind, this is a gunfighter wildcard build. You do have to equip this in order to be able to put on all the attachments that are featured here. For the optic, it's optional. You can use whatever you want, but I do recommend something like the mil stock or the Cobra red dot or even the Microflex LED. You know, pay attention to how much it actually magnifies. So for example, the Microflex LED, it's says here it magnifies 1.25 times, and then the mil stop is 1.37, Cobra is 1.75. So just depending on your personal preference, what you're comfortable with, just go with either or, you know, go into a private match and then test it out and see how it works out for you. But for me, I like the mil stop reflex. That one's a happy medium for me. Muzzle, I'm going to be using the Muzzle Break 9. Of course, we want that pro of vertical recoil control. We do not want any cons at all whatsoever. The other attachments here are very solid attachment choices. And then on top of that, like I said, you could either go with the reinforced heavy barrel or the Ranger, just depending on how big or small the map is. As far as most 6v6 maps in this game goes, and I'm playing relatively close to my opponents within that 30 meter range, the reinforced heavy is a pretty solid choice in my opinion. But like I said, on a much larger map where your engagements are going to be a much longer range, like Checkmate for example, or Satellite, you definitely want to go with the Ranger. But on a smaller map, go with the reinforced heavy. Body, again, we're going to be using that Tiger Team Spotlight, and underbarrel is going to be the Field Agent grip. We have two pros of vertical recoil control and a big boost in horizontal recoil control. Magazine is pretty much anything you want to go with. Handle is going to be the Airborne Elastic Wrap. And for stock, we're going to be going with the Raider stock. Just to clarify with this class setup, remember, this setup is more for the beginner or somebody who just has a hard time having a better accuracy when they're shooting their opponents. This will definitely give you a lot more confidence to win those gunfights. All the rest here is just completely optional. You can use whatever you want. However, if you're going to be using this no recoil setup, I do recommend the Assault Pack, because what I had in mind with this no recoil setup is that you're mostly going to be playing at a distance. So if you're playing at a distance, that means that you're not going to be nearby enough to enemies to pick up their scavenger packs. Perks, you can use whatever you want, whatever you're comfortable with, but I do recommend cold-blooded, because if you're going to be playing at a distance, cold-blooded is going to keep you safe from dying to enemy airstreaks. Moving on to the stealth MP5 class setup. So this is more of like a flanking, sneaky type of playstyle. So this one, we're going to be using the sound suppressor for our muzzle. This one gives us that 100% muzzle flash concealment. If it's not 100% muzzle flash concealment, then it is not going to keep you hidden from the enemy radar when you're firing your weapon. So when you think of stealth, obviously you think of being hidden. Now, there is a con of effective damage range, but that's okay, because we're going to cancel that out by adding the reinforced heavy barrel. For magazine, you can again use whatever you want. It's all personal choice. And then for the handle, I'm going to be using the Airborne Elastic Wrap. This could be helpful when you're flanking enemies, because they could turn around and maybe you might want a drop shot to give yourself a higher chance of winning that gunfight. Stock again is going to be the Raider stock. All right, so what I like to do when I'm playing stealth is I like to hold an area down and then move on to another area, get a couple kills, etc. I do recommend putting on the field mic. That way, when you start to notice a pattern of where the enemies are spawning in from and where they're coming in from, you definitely want to put a field mic in that area, but of course keep it hidden so that they can't see it. And then you'll be able to predict enemy movement so much easier, and you're going to be a lot more stealth that way. They're not going to expect you coming from whatever direction you may come from, because you've got the field mic. For running perk greed, that way we can apply all these perks here. These are very important for staying stealthy and staying alive as long as possible. Paranoia is going to help us out when we're moving around the map, we're flanking, you know, we're sticking to the outskirts. There's a pretty good chance that you might miss an enemy who's walking near you. Paranoia is going to start to make this sound. Also, you're going to see this yellow highlight depending what angle you're being seen at on your screen, and that's why paranoia is a very, very powerful perk. And then next we have forward intel. We want as much intel as possible, so this will literally make you see more on the mini map, and that's going to give you more information of where, which direction you need to push. And also at the same time, it shows you when the spawns flip. Tracker is very helpful as well. When you're flanking enemies, you literally see their footprints on the ground. Just follow it straight up and get the easy kill. And it takes the guesswork when you're trying to figure out where an opponent is. Then we have Ghost and Ninja, two very, very important perks. These are crutch perks in my opinion. Moving on to the aggressive class setup. So this is my aggressive MP5 build. So we're not worried about stealth. We're not worried about the objective. We're literally just worried about trying to down our opponents as fast as possible in the most aggressive way possible. You know, we don't really care about dying and stuff like that. This is just pure firepower right here. All right, so for the barrel, we're going to be running with that reinforced heavy barrel. Again, same reasoning as earlier before. And then for the underbarrel, we're using the bruiser grip. So this has so many pros to it. They are a bit of a boost, probably not going to be noticeable, but it is going to help you out in gunfights. So we got more movement speed, we got sprinting move speed, shooting move speed, and aim walking movement speed, because it gives us the most amount of pros without any cons to it. For the magazine, I do recommend using a fast mag. You want to be able to reload your weapon as fast as possible to get you ready for the next gunfight. If you're playing aggressive, up close and personal, this is very important. So use whatever you want as long as the reload quickness is faster on that magazine. So handle is going to be the Airborne Elastic Wrap. Once again, we want to be able to drop shot in certain situations, and then also that 30% boost and aim down sight time is going to help us out, because speed and aggressiveness do go hand in hand. So for the stock, again, we're running with the Raider stock. You cannot go wrong with the Raider stock. I think by now you know that this is one of my favorite attachments. Secondary, I do prefer a shotgun. You know, if you're going to be running around, let's just say you're caught in those instances where you simply don't have enough time to reload, pull out the shotgun, boom, it'll get the job done for you for that specific time, and then you can go back to your MP5 and reload. Tactical is going to be stim shot. This is going to be be crucial for healing yourself as quickly as possible. It'll give you more confidence to go back into that gunfight or flee from the scene without being shot. Lethal is going to be Semtex, field upgrade, put a proximity mine. I like to put proximity mines generally in areas where I'm holding down areas so that I know when an enemy is nearby, if it pops off and it doesn't kill somebody, or you might get lucky and actually kill somebody. Perks are going to be Scavenger, Ghost, and Gung-Ho. Gung-Ho probably the most important perk here if you're trying to play aggressive, because it'll give you the ability to fire your weapon and use equipment while sprinting. So this is very, very useful if you want to play as aggressive as possible. And how I'm able to have all these perks here is because I have the Lawbreaker wild card. So that's very important to note. Last but not least, we've got the balanced MP5. Probably my number one favorite setup here because it's got a great balance. That's why I call it balance of stealth, aggression, speed, etc. So let's go over the attachments. We got the sound suppressor. Barrel is going to be the 9.5 inch reinforced heavy. Magazine is going to be the 40 round speed mag. Handle is going to be the serpent grip. And the Raider stock is going to be for the stock. Now, one thing that's a little different is I'm using the serpent grip here versus the airborne elastic wrap, because I want to minimize the amount of cons as much as possible on this class setup. Now, as you can see, the airborne elastic wrap, it reduces your shooting move speed as well as your sprint to fire time. So, you know, I don't really want those cons. That's why I'm putting on the serpent grip. And then there's only one small tiny con of sprint to fire time, but that's okay because we have the Raider stock, which completely negates that sprint to fire time negative. And then moving on to the secondary, use whatever you want. Tactical, lethal, all this stuff is optional. Perks are going to be very similar here to the stealth setup with a few tweaks here. I've got the tac mask for my perk one, and then also paranoia under perk one. Perk 2, I've got Assassin, and then Scavenger, and then Ghost and Ninja. All right, so that about wraps it up for today's video. Again, if you found this video helpful, informational, at any point in the video, make sure to drop a like on this video and subscribe if you're brand new around here for more Call of Duty Cold War class setups. Let's go, baby.